Welcome to Cook 30. I'm Jeremy Dixon from the Revive Cafes in Auckland, New Zealand, and also author of the Revive Cafe Cookbooks. And today, I'm going to share with you some delicious cafe-style meals that you can cook at home. Cook 30 food is all about using plant-based whole foods. We're going to be using lots of grains like quinoa and brown rice, protein sources like beans, nuts, and lentils, fresh fruit and vegetables, and tying it all together with international flavours and fresh herbs and spices. And the best part about Cook 30 food is you do not have to spend hours slaving away in the kitchen to make it. I'm going to show you how you can make a tasty meal for your family in just 30 minutes, and your family will love it. On the menu today, we have a spinach, ginger, pumpkin, and tofu curry served over freshly cooked quinoa. We have a revived raw salad with beetroot and mint, and a corn and pepper fiesta. And to finish it off, a lovely sweet and honest pina colada. Okay, if you want to cook meals in a hurry, you've got to make sure you're well prepared. They don't happen by accident. You want to start with a nice clear work surface. Make sure it's all clear and clean. Chopping board on a wet tea towel to make sure it doesn't slip. Sharp knife. We've got two pots on the stove, hot and ready to go. The jug is boiled with hot water. The oven is on at 350 Fahrenheit, or about 180 Celsius. And our fridge and pantry are stocked with all the food we're going to need. So let's get started. First job is the quinoa. So we've got a hot pan here. Ooh. And we're going to use some quinoa. And quinoa is a great nutritious grain to use. And a very simple recipe. 1 cup of quinoa to 2 cups of water. And we're going to use boiling water. And this will just cut down the cooking time. When you're cooking fast, you don't have time to sit around waiting for water to boil. Yep, that pan is nice and hot. So 1 cup of quinoa to 2 cups of water. Same recipe as rice. Two other rules in cooking quinoa. Number one is lid on. We're using the absorption method, which means we want the moisture to go inside the quinoa, not evaporate off the top. And also, you never want to stir it. Little steam vents will appear in the quinoa, which actually cook it. If you start stirring it all the time, you destroy those steam vents and inhibit its ability to be able to be cooked. So we've got that on, really hot, and it's starting to bubble now. So when it's bubbling, we want to turn it down. So it's just on a really low heat, and it should be just bubbling. And that'll take around about 15 minutes to cook. It's a really fast grain, so it's great. Okay, second job is the butternut pumpkin. And this is going to be a great ingredient for our curry. So we're going to cut this in half. And with butternut, half has the seeds in it and half doesn't. We're going to use this half for the sake of speed and use the other half later. And we're just going to chop it up into cubes. So just cut nice long strips. You want to cut it so it's nice and thin so that it's going to cook really quickly. Just chop lovely slices like that. Now we're leaving the skin on. Butternut, and most pumpkin for that matter, has lovely soft skin when it's cooked. So it's going to save time, it's going to add greater quantity to our meal, and also it means we're not going to waste any. And also all the vitamins and minerals that are in it as well. So just chop that up like that. So it goes very lovely and sweet when it's roasted. There we go. Splash of oil over the top. Throw in about a tablespoon. And we're just going to mingle that around so it's nicely coated. There we go. And pop that straight in the oven. Okay, that's the second job done. Now we want to get the curry on. Just check, we've got a nice hot pan. So I'm going to grab an onion. This is always a good way to start. Oh, that's a bit of a rotten one. This one looks better. Good way to start a curry is always an onion. Lovely sweet base and depth of flavour. So we'll just chop, take the skin off, which is the hard part. Come on. go. I'm just going to slice it up just into chunks. Not super fine, we haven't got all day to make tiny bits of onion, but just so it's nicely cubed, and that'll cook up really quickly. Splash of oil in the pan. I'm using a cast iron pot today. These are my favourite. You can also use a stainless steel or a non-stick fry pan, anything you want really, or just even a basic pot. But I love cast iron because they really hold a nice even flavour. So if you can get one, make sure you get one. Onions on. I'm going to use some garlic. Garlic and onions are always a good way to start a lot of meals. So I've got two cloves of garlic. I've got my garlic press. Let's put the garlic straight in there. And we'll squeeze it in. Look how fast that is. Good time-saving trick. Lovely. The next ingredient we want is some ginger. And I'm going to use one of these ginger purees that you can get from the supermarket. It's just ginger and a little bit of oil. So we only have 2 tablespoons of that. You can use freshly chopped ginger if you want, but this stuff is excellent. However, never use the garlic that comes from the supermarket in those tubes. You always must use garlic nice and fresh. There's something about those tubes that doesn't really work with garlic, but the ginger is perfectly acceptable. So that's well underway, and we've got a great start on our meal. I've got a really simple salad that's so quick and you're going to love. This is a corn and pepper fiesta. We're going to start with two tins of corn. This is just whole kernel corn. I'm just going to drain it to start with. You could use corn from frozen corn if you wanted to, or even better if you had fresh corn on the cob. But for most purposes, canned corn is excellent. And we're just going to mix it in the bowl that we're going to serve it from. There's one, and there's two. Slightly different colours. And we're just going to add lots of lovely, colourful ingredients. So we're going to start with the red pepper, or capsicum, depending on what country you're from. And we're just going to dice this up really fine. So just make it into long strips. And more long strips. Don't worry about if the odd pepper seed gets in there. Then turn it around and we're going to cut it through here. Try to economise on your cuts as much as you can. The less cuts you can do, the faster your meal will be. There we go. Lovely colour. First rule when cooking and for salads is colour. So you want to always add lots of different colours. I'm going to add some scallions or spring onions. So just line up the ends, slice them off. Take some of the ends here off as well. Chop it in half. And then we're going to do the same thing. Just slice through really thin. When you're slicing, make sure your knife makes contact with the board each time. And you're sliding the knife through the spring onion. And that way you're going to get a really nice clean cut. You don't want too many bits that are joined together. So make sure you make a good contact with the board each time. Mix those in as well. Those beautiful colours. Whoops. We're going to do an avocado. Avocado is a great ingredient to add to a salad. Chop it in half, give it a twist, then grab the stone, twist it out, get the stone off the side, then we're just going to peel the skin off and cube it up. If we can get it off. There we go. One half and second half. So just really finely cube it. Just to match the theme of this dish, it's not a chunky salad, it's a very fine salad with the corn and the peppers. So try and keep this really fine. There we go. That's the avocado. We're going to add some lime juice. So just get a lime. Or two limes. So you want around about 4 tablespoons of lime juice. And we're just going to juice them in this juicer. and pour that over. And this will help the avocado from going brown as well. Just a dash of olive oil. About a quarter of a teaspoon of salt. And we're just going to mix that through with our hands. And look at those beautiful colours. We've literally made the salad in a couple of minutes, and you know this is going to taste good with all that lime juice and all those delicious flavours, and it's going to just look a treat on the table. So that's finished and ready to go. There are three spices that go together really well, and you want to make sure you've got them in your pantry. And that is these, turmeric, coriander, and cumin. They go together really well, and especially in this curry. So we want to give them, activate them with a bit of heat. So we want to put a tablespoon of each into the curry. You can smell them straight away. You want to make sure spices do get a bit of heat activation. That way they'll work better. And turmeric has great medicinal properties as well. So we're just going to stir these around and just activate that heat. So we've got that beautiful sweet onion in there as a base with the garlic and the ginger and these three spices. You know it's going to taste really great. That's all you need, just a few seconds in there. And then we're going to add some tomatoes. So we've got a big can, so you can use two small cans or one big can. And you want to use tomatoes that are crushed or are quite, got a nice thick texture like this. If it is like tomato chunks and water, you want to make sure you blend it first with a stick blender. So we're going to pour that in and mix that around. Our curry is well underway. I'm going to add some sweetener, so we have honey, that's my favourite sweetener. You can make up your own date puree or use egg guave. So 2 tablespoons of honey. We're going to put in a teaspoon of salt. And some tofu. Now tofu gets a reputation for being very bland and boring, but I'm about to shatter that reputation with this beautiful dish. But the good thing about tofu is it sucks up flavours really nicely, so that's why I like using it. So give that a bit of a stir. So just get a firm tofu, available in pretty much most supermarkets these days. And we're just going to cube it, drain the water out, just into little cubes. So just keep the block together and economise on your cutting. Just in little 1/2 inch or 1 centimetre cubes. And we're going to put this in the curry, and this will just soak up all that beautiful flavour that's in there. Tofu is a great protein source, and you only want a protein component at most meals. Look at that. So we're going to let this curry just sit here and just mingle with these flavours for the next 10 minutes or so. And right at the end we'll add the pumpkin, butternut pumpkin, and some coconut cream and some spinach. So the main work for this is now done. If you've just joined us on Cook 30, we are cooking a delicious meal in just 30 minutes. On the menu today we have a spinach, ginger, pumpkin and tofu curry. And we're serving this on freshly cooked quinoa. We have a revived raw salad with beetroot and mint, and a corn and pepper fiesta. And to finish off, a delicious dessert, an honest pina colada. Okay, let's make the raw salad. And this is probably the most popular salad in my cafes, and we have it on the menu virtually all year round. It's just delicious. So first step, we're going to have some raisins. And what we're going to do is, raisins come quite dry generally, so we just want to just plumpen them up a bit. So here's a really neat trick. So we want about a cup of raisins. We're just going to put some boiling or very hot water over them. And in literally a couple of minutes, these will turn from little dry raisins to really plump ones that we can add to our salad. So we'll just put those aside there for the moment. Now, when you've got your food processor, you'll probably find in the back of the cupboard, there are all these wonderful little blades that you've never used before. And they come grating and slicing blades, and this is a grating blade, and you can produce huge amounts of salad in very short time. So I've got this grating blade that's the biggest setting. And we're going to start with some beetroot and carrots. So these beetroot are just beautiful vegetables and lovely raw. If you've never had it raw, you've just got to try it. So we want around about 4 cups of grated stuff all up. Now this one's really clean, it doesn't really need any tidying up. This one here, there's some rough bits on them, take them off. But in general, most of the skin is generally okay to use. So we just need to chop it up to the size that it's going to fit in the hole of the food processor. And we're just going to start pushing it down. Just like that. And look at that beautiful beetroot. Literally 20 seconds, very fast. Before we open it, we're going to get these carrots. These carrots look like they need a peel. Usually you can get away with not peeling carrots, but it just depends on how they look and how old they are. It's not carrot season at the moment. Just give them a quick peel. We'll just chop the ends off. And they can join their friends beetroot in the food processor. And look at what we have in here. You get a few bits that kind of miss the grating blade, but check out this beautiful texture of carrot and beetroot. Isn't that beautiful? So we're going to put it into the bowl we're going to serve from. Just give it a mix around while we go. Take out any bits that have floated through. Just look at that colour. Just full of enzymes and nutrients and flavour. Absolutely beautiful. So we'll just give it a bit of a mix around just so it is slightly mixed. Pull out any bits. And that's pretty much the bulk of that salad. So now, I'm here. We want to add some sunflower seeds as well. And that just mixes through and gives it a lovely bit of crunch. And we're going to make a little dressing now. So we're just going to mix together some orange juice. So an orange dressing. It goes really well with these flavours. So I'm just going to juice one orange, and you can use orange juice if you must, but there's nothing like juicing a fresh orange for the salad. As you can tell, beetroot colour goes everywhere. There's the orange. I'm going to juice a lemon just for a bit of tartness, just to make it more interesting and zingy. Going to pour it through my fingers to catch the pips. And we're going to add a tablespoon of honey, just a bit of healthy sweetening, and a touch of salt. Just give this a bit of a stir up, and that's all it is, just a very simple sweet dressing with a lovely orange flavour. I might just put a little bit of touch of olive oil in there as well. And then we're going to just pour it over the salad. And to finish off, we want some mint. Mint is lovely, lovely with these flavours. So a big handful of mint. Chop it up, slice it up. Not too thinly. This just smells amazing. Put it over that and mix it through, and that is how easy the salad is. Oh, don't forget the sultanas. We'll just drain those. And that just adds a lovely, plump, delicious flavour. And that is just a juicy, delicious flavour and will become one of your favourite salads within a very short time. Okay, let's see how the pumpkin's going. Look at that, beautiful. So we'll just check it's done. Yep, nice and soft. So we're just gonna spoon it into here. It's a little bit stuck, but that's okay. This is just lovely and soft and just goes really, really well with this curry. Okay, and now we want some spinach. So we're going to use some chopped frozen spinach. You can use normal spinach if you want, but this is, I find, the easiest to use. Just put this over here out the way. So we just want 2 cups of chopped spinach. Let's pour it in there. And that'll just defrost reasonably quickly in that lovely hot mix. Get rid of that. Give it a stir around. This is my favourite part, when all the ingredients are in and you can stir all the lovely ingredients, everything together. Look at that. So that spinach will continue to defrost before we serve, so there's no rush to get that cooked. And we're also going to stir in a little bit of coconut milk. So 1/2 can of coconut milk. Like that, look at that. Looking absolutely beautiful. So that base with all those spices and onions and garlic and ginger, combined with the lovely tomatoes, honey, tofu, pumpkin, and the pumpkin will kind of dissolve and make it creamier as well. So to finish with that, we're just going to just keep warming for a bit. I'm just going to cut up some cilantro to put on top. This is how I keep my herbs in the fridge. Just wrap them in a wet paper towel and they'll keep for ages. So we're just going to slice some of this, and that there is now a curry that is ready. Looks great. Better finish the quinoa. That's all cooked. So we're just going to spoon it into this platter, just like this. Just see how it's lovely and fluffy. And this is just a lovely grain that's high in protein and is just really delicious. And it cooks really quickly too. So if you want a grain in a hurry, it's great. And we've got some left over here. Make sure you put it in a plastic container in the fridge and have it for breakfast, or we can use it to make a stir fry another day. So it's really, really good to have it when it is the next day. And over the top, we're just going to put some sliced almonds just to make it look a little bit pretty, a little bit cared for. And just simple like that. We don't need to add anything else to it. There's a lot of flavour in the curry to go with. Okay, we better finish with the smoothie. Now, one ingredient you want in your freezer is frozen bananas. And you need to do this ahead of time. And this is just a great smoothie ingredient. So you just come like this, put bananas in, take the skins off, chop them into chunks like that. And they'll just come apart reasonably free flowing. So we've got 2 bananas there. We've got 1 can of pineapple. Any kind of pineapple will do as long as it's unsweetened. You don't want stuff that has syrup, you want to make sure it's sweetened in its own juice. So 1 large can there. I'm going to put the bananas in, and this will make the honest Pina Colada. Gonna put a tablespoon of honey. Depending on the bananas and how ripe they were when you put them in, you may need to adjust the honey. And we're going to add just the remainder of our coconut cream to give it the authentic Pina Colada type texture. So let's blend this and see how it goes. Okay, that's looking nice and silky. Check that out. Beautiful pie. I can smell the pineapple from here. It's absolutely delicious. That pineapple and coconut cream and that banana give it a really nice texture. Look at that. Make sure they're even. Don't want to shortchange anyone. There we go. Just a sprinkle of nutmeg over the top just to give it a little bit of something special. And that is finished as well. So looks like everything's done in our lovely 30 minute meal. The curry's finished, lovely and warm. Healthy quinoa. We've got the beetroot salad. This is an amazing salad. And of course we have the corn fiesta, which is absolutely delicious. And there you have a delicious meal in just 30 minutes. Ever since I started using whole food, plant-based ingredients in my life, and eating healthy and exercising, I found I have so much more energy and vitality, and life is just great when you have those things. So I'd encourage you to cook healthy and not eat the default meals that you find in the supermarket, which are loaded with sugars and all these processed ingredients. Try ingredients like this. We've got the beautiful spinach, ginger, pumpkin, tofu curry on quinoa. We have the raw salad, which is a favorite at my cafes, and the corn and pepper fiesta. Delicious food. Oh, and don't forget the honest pina colada, which you will love. Thank you for joining me today on Cook 30, and I look forward to seeing you next time.